We're being attacked. This is what I heard when I answered the phone. Someone was calling me from the Ebola Treatment Center in Butembo, Congo. This gave us time to reflect on what hadn't been working in the Ebola outbreak and how we wanted to be working in the Ebola outbreak in the future. All the organizations involved in responding to Ebola, including MSF, we all jumped into the emergency response. We sent hundreds of staff, we sent tons of material, we did things really quickly, but what didn't happen was engaging with the community, building the trust of the community, and really looking at the context that this outbreak was happening in, and this we didn't do. So MSF, we started to build wells. Everything that we will do, we will engage with the community. We will make sure that we're asking them what their priorities are, and we will do activities with them. We started to ensure that we provided treatment for the diseases that people were dying from malaria, from measles, from diarrhea. And when we built Ebola isolations, we built them with the community. This could set a precedent for future outbreaks where it seems to be okay to be using coercion and armed escorts and not building the trust of the community. Thankfully, the numbers of Ebola cases has really reduced. My fear is that when this outbreak finally comes to an end, all of the actors involved in the Ebola response will congratulate themselves and say that the outbreak ended because of how they managed it, where in fact, it ended despite of how they managed it.